ओम श्री साईराम वेलकम टू श्री सत्यसाई लोकसेवा गुरुकुलम सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग द प्लेइंग विथ नंबर्स सिक्स्थ स्टैंडर्ड मैथमेटिक्स इन द लास्ट वीडियो सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द मीनिंग ऑफ फैक्टर्स एंड मल्टीपल्स द मीनिंग एंड डेफिनेशंस ऑफ प्राइम नंबर्स कॉम्पोजिट नंबर्स को प्राइम नंबर्स पिन प्राइम्स परफेक्ट नंबर्स and of course you know the even numbers and odd numbers from the beginning at the end of the last video few questions were given for the assignment let us discuss the answer for those assignments the first question was fill up the blanks a number which has only two factors is called so the answer is prime number so prime numbers have two and only two factors the smallest prime number is 2 and the second question is the smallest composite number so remember 1 is neither prime nor composite 2 is the least or the first prime number 2 is the only even prime number so 3 is the second prime number 3 has only two factors therefore this is the second prime number and the next number is 4 so it has three factors the factors of 4 are so 1 2 and 4 itself so as 4 is the first number which has three factors therefore 4 is the first composite number sum of any two prime number is an even number this sentence is asked for true or false so it is false because you know that 2 is a prime number 2 and 3 are two prime numbers their sum is not an even number it is an odd number so it is not always true if you take other than 2 if you take any two prime numbers other than 2 so then always we get an even number so generally it is false the next question write five pairs of twin primes so you know that if the difference between any two prime numbers any two consecutive prime numbers is 2 then they are called pin prime numbers here 3 and 5 are prime numbers their difference is 2 5 and 7 are prime numbers their difference is 2 so these are the examples for pin primes next question give two examples for a pair of composite numbers which are coprime so if two numbers do not have any other common facts other than 1 then they are called coprime numbers here 8 is a composite number 21 is also a composite number but their common factor is only 1 they do not have any other common factors other than 1 so therefore they are called coprime numbers similarly 4 and 9 so both are composite numbers but their common factor is 1 therefore they are called coprime numbers so express 44 and 18 as the sum of two odd prime numbers so we can write 3 plus 41 you can write in another way also you think it so 18 can be written as 5 plus 13 the sum of two prime numbers So these were the questions given in the last video as assignment. So remember, in the first video, we started with a game of distributing chocolates. So there we asked to distribute 12 chocolates equally to 3 members, equally to 4 members, equally to 5 members, and then we find that it is not possible to distribute 12 chocolates to 5 members equally. So then we told that because 5 is not the factor of 12. Here's another similar question. Is it possible to distribute 200 chocolates to 11 students or 11 children? So what we have to do here? Here we have to find whether 11 is the factor of 200, whether 11 divides 200. So how will you do? So you start dividing 200 by 11 so 11 ones are 11 So 9 remainder, you get 90. So then 11, 8 is 88. 2 remains. The remainder is not 0. Therefore, 11 will not divide 200. So it is not possible to distribute 200 chocolates to 11 students equally. So we can say this statement in 3 different types. So no, 200 chocolates cannot be distributed among 11 students equally. So we can state it as 200 is not divisible by 11. So we can also say that 11 is not the factor of 200. So in another sentence we can tell it as 200 is not a multiple of 11. So remember the 3 sentences here. 200 is not divisible by 11, or we can say 11 is not the factor of 200, or we can say 200 is not the multiple of 11 table. In 11's table you will not have 200. So among the factors of 200, 11 will not come. So that means 200 is not divisible by 11. So consider another example. Is it possible to divide the number 13,582 by 2 or 3 or 5 or 6 or by any another given number? So how will you do? So we start dividing 13,582 by the given another number. So is it the only way? No, there are another easy methods. There are some rules. By learning those rules, we can tell whether the given number is divisible by another given number without actual division. So this method is called actual division. So without actual division, we can find out whether the given one number is divisible by given another number. So let us discuss those rules, few of those rules in this video. So they are called divisibility tests. Using divisibility rules, or you can call them as divisibility tests. Let us see some rules. So divisibility by 10, that means, so which are the numbers which are divisible by 10? So everybody know that if a number has 0 in its units place, ones place, then all those numbers are divisible by 10. So any number having 0 at the right end, I will take 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 0 at the end. So that means 1,23,780. As its units place is 0, this entire number is divisible by 10. So divisibility by 10 is, if a number has 0 in its ones place, then that number is divisible by 10. Divisibility by 5. So any number have 0 or 5 in its units place, then that number is divisible by 5. So 5, 10, you can remember the 5th table. So in the 5th table we have either 5 or 0 in its unit place. So therefore any number which contains 0 or 5 in the unit place, those numbers are divisible by 5. So then divisibility by 2. So you will already know these rules. So all even numbers are divisible by 2. So you know what are even numbers. So 2, 4, 6, 8, then 10, and all other numbers which have either 2 or 4 or 6 or 8 or 0 in the unit place are called even numbers. So all those even numbers are divisible by 2. Let's go to the next rule. Divisibility by 3. To check whether the given number is divisible by 10 or 5 or 2, so we will look at the unit place of the number. That means the rightmost digit of the number. So 37569. To check whether this number is divisible by 10 or 5 or 2, just we check the unit place of the number. If it is 0, the unit place is 0, then that number is divisible by 10. Here it is 9, it is not divisible by 10. If the unit place of the number is 5 or 0, then that number is divisible by 5. Here the number is 9, therefore it is not divisible by 5. And in the unit place, if we have 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, then we call that number as even number, and all even numbers are divisible by 2. But the divisibility by 3, test for the rule for 3 is slightly different. It is not possible by only looking at the unit place of the number. The rule is, if the sum of the digits of the given number is multiple of 3, then that number is divisible by 3. So here we have to add all the digits of the given number. So here we have to add 3 plus 7 plus 5 plus 6 plus 9. It gives, so 3, 10, 15, then 21, 30. Here sum of the digits is 30. Once again you can add the digits. 3 plus 0 is 3. The sum of the digits is divisible by 3. It is the multiple of 3. Therefore this entire number is also divisible by 3. So remember, if the sum of all the digits of the given number is divisible by 3, then that entire number is also divisible by 3. So here a question is given here. 7689, whether it is divisible by 3. So what we have to do? We have to add the digits. 7 plus 6 plus 8 plus 9. So 7, this is 13, then 21. 21 plus 9, again here also 30. So 30 is divisible by 3. Therefore, this number is also divisible by 3. Next, divisibility by 6. So this is also slightly different from the other numbers. If a number is divisible by both 3 and 2, then that number is also divisible by 6. So you know that all the even numbers are divisible by 3, and if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. So that means all even numbers which are divisible by 3 are divisible by 6. So that means the numbers which are divisible by 6 are only even numbers. No odd number is divisible by 6. Here, check whether 72,414 and some 2 lakh, some big number is given. Okay, 24,73,895 are divisible by 6. Here, the first number is an even number. To check whether this number is divisible by 6, we have to check whether this number is divisible by 3 at first. If it is divisible by 3, then it is also divisible by 6. Look at the second number. It is an odd number. So no odd number is divisible by 6. So directly we can say that this number is not divisible by 6 because it is an odd number. No odd number is divisible by 6. For this, we have to check whether this is divisible by 3. So add the digits 7, then 9, 13, 15, sorry, 13, 14, 14 plus 4 is 18. So 18 is divisible by 3. 18 comes in third table. Or once again, you can add the digits. 1 plus 8 is 9. So 9 comes in third table. Therefore, this number is divisible by 3. It is an even number. Therefore, it is also divisible by 6. So remember, no odd number is divisible by 6. If the given number is even number, and if it is divisible by 3, then it is also divisible by 6. All even numbers which are divisible by 3 are also divisible by 6. No odd number is divisible by 6. Divisibility by 4. The number formed by the last two digits is divisible by 4, then the entire number is also divisible by 4. If the number formed by the last two digits. So here a big number is given, that is 32,21,716 is given. The number formed by the last two digits is 16 here. So 16 is divisible by 4. In the fourth table we have 16. So therefore this entire number is also divisible by 4. The rule for divisibility by 8 is similar to the divisibility rule of 4. But only the difference is here we have to take the number formed by the last three digits. If a number formed by the last three digits of the given number is divisible by 8, then the entire number is also divisible by 8. So here is an example is given. Here the number formed by the last three digits is 576. So for this you can do the actual division. So take 576, divide with 8. So 8 sevens are 56, 1 remains, 6 carries. So 16, 8 twos are 16, the remainder is 0. That means 576 is divisible by 8. Therefore, this 852,576 is also divisible by 8. So if the number formed by the last three digits of the given number is divisible by 8, then that entire number is also divisible by 8. So divisibility by 9, this is similar to the rule of 3. So the divisibility rule for 3 is you have to add the digits, and the sum of, if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. So here also we have to add the digits. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, then that entire number is also divisible by 9. Small numbers are given. I will give another number, 37265. To check whether this number is divisible by 9, we have to add the digits. So add 3, 7, 2, 6 and 5. So 3, then 10, then 12, 18. 18 plus 5 is 23. So 23 is not divisible by 9. Therefore, this whole number is also not divisible by 9. The next test, divisibility by 11. If the difference between sum of the odd place digits and sum of the even place digits is divisible by 11, then the number is divisible by 11. So what is this? The digits of odd places and the digits of even places. So look at this number. Here, this is in the unit place, first place. This is in the second place. So this is in the third place, this is fourth place, this is fifth place. If I count from right side, then this 5, 2 and 3 are the digits of odd places. First place, third place and fifth place, the digits of odd places. This is 7 and 6. So they are in the second place and fourth place. That means they are in the even places. So to check whether this number is divisible by 11, we have to take the sum of odd places and sum of even places, and then we have to take their differences. So look at this number. Here the sum of the digits of odd places is 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 3 is 10. This is the sum of digits of odd places, and the sum of the digits of even places is 7 plus 6. So that is 13. Now we have to take the difference of these two numbers. Their difference is not 0, not 11, not 22. If the difference is 0 or 11 or 22 or 33 or the multiples of 11, then that number is divisible by 11. Here the difference is not 0, not 11. Therefore, this number, that is 37,265, is not divisible by 11. Here another example is given. That is 61,809. Here the sum of the odd place digits is 9 plus 8 plus 6. So 9 plus 8 is 17, 17 plus 6 is 23. The sum of the digits of odd places, and the sum of the digits of even places, the second place and this is the fourth place, their sum is 1 plus 0 is 1, and the difference 23 minus 1 is 22. So it comes in 11th table. Therefore, this entire number is divisible by 11. Hope you understood these divisibility tests for 10, 5, 2, and then for 3, 4, 8, 9, and 11. Let us play a game. Here, 7, 5, 8, 2. Here, consider A as a digit. The question is, write all possible values of A if 7, 5, 8, 2 is divisible by, the first question is 3, second question is 4, third question is 11. So what value of A makes this number divisible by 3? So you know that if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then that whole number is also divisible by 3. So take the sum. The sum of the digits is 7 plus 5 plus 8 plus 2. That is 7 plus 5 is 12. 12 plus 2 is 14. We cannot add A to 14. Therefore, it is 14 plus A. So now we have to find out for what value of A this number 14 plus A is divisible by 3. So remember the third table and the numbers which comes in the third table after 14. So in the third table we have 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 18, 10 21, 24, 27, 30. So third table, the numbers greater than 14 which comes in the third table are 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 3 7s are 3 8s are. These are the numbers. So to make this number 15, what is the value of A? So it is 1. So that means in the place of A, if you have 1, that is 7512, that number is divisible by 3. The possible value of A is 1. To get the sum 18, what will be the value of A? Yes, it is 4. 14 plus 4 is 18. So that means 7,005, if we put A as 4, 7,542, it is also divisible by 3. So therefore, 4 is another value of A. To get 21, 14 plus 7 is 21. So therefore, 7 is another value. To get 24, yes, to get 24, we need 10. 14 plus 10 is 24, but here A is a single digit. 10 is a two-digit number. So therefore, we cannot write 10 here. So therefore, the all possible values of A which make this number divisible by 3 is only 1, 4, and 7. So take the second question. What value of A make this number divisible by 4? So what is the rule? The number formed by the last two digits must be divisible by 4. So if I put 0 here, so 0, 2, 2 is not divisible by 4. So therefore 0 is not the answer. If I put 1, we get 12. In the last 2 places we have 12. So therefore 12 is divisible by 4. That means 7512. It is divisible by 4. Therefore one of the value for A to make it divisible by 4 is 1. Then if you put 2 here, 22 is not divisible by 4. 32 is divisible by 4. So therefore we can write 3 here. In the place of A, we can have 3. 42 is not divisible by 4. 52. So 13 4s are, 4 13s are 52. So we can write 5. Then 72 is divisible by 4. 82 will not divisible by 4. Then 92 is divisible by 4. So these are the possible values of A which makes this number divisible by 4. Then remember the divisibility test for 11. So here we have to take the sum of the odd places digits and even places digits. Sum of the odd place digits is 5 plus 2, 7. Sum of odd place digits is 5 plus 2, that is 7. And the sum of even place digits is 7 plus A. To make this number divisible by 11, the difference of 7 and 7 plus A must be 0 or 11 or 22 or any number which comes in 11th table. To make the difference 0, we have to put A is equal to 0. So if I put 0 here, that is 7502, then the difference between the sum of the digits of even place and sum of the digits of odd place becomes 0. That means that number is divisible by 11. So therefore one of the possible value of A which makes this number divisible by 11 is 0. So then to make the difference 11, so this number must be 11 more than 7, 11 plus 7. That means we have to get 18 here. 7 plus A is equal to 18. That means A is equal to 18 minus 7. So 18 minus 7 is nothing but 11. 11 is not a single digit. It is a two digit number. So we can't write 11 here. Here we have to write only a one digit. Therefore, only the possible value of A to make this number divisible by 11 is 0. Let's look at the next question. Okay, now look at some more divisibility rules. If a number is divisible by another number, then it is divisible by each of the factors of that number. So take an example, 24. So you know that 24 is divisible by 12. 12 twos are 24. If I take the factors of 12, so you know that 1 is the factor of any number. So 2 divides 12, 2 is a factor of 12. From 3 we can divide 12, 3 is a factor of 12. From 4 we can divide 12, 4 is a factor of 12. Then 5 is not the factor of 12, 6 is a factor, then 12 itself is a factor. If 24 is divisible by 12, that implies 24 is also divisible by this 2, this 3, this 4, this 6 also. If a number is divisible by another number, then that given number is also divisible by the factors of another number. Here 2, 3, 4 and 6 are all the different factors of 12. 24 is divisible by 12 implies it is also divisible by 2, 3, 4 and 6. If a number is divisible by 2 co-prime numbers, then it is also divisible by their products. the product of those two co-prime numbers. Look at here, 80 is divisible by 4, 80 is also divisible by 5. Here 4 and 5 are co-prime numbers. Therefore, this 80 is also divisible by the product of 4 and 5. 4 5s are 20. It is also divisible by 20. So, if a number is divisible by 8 and that number is also divisible by 15, then that number is also divisible by the product of 8 and 15. Here 8 and 15 are co-prime numbers. They do not have any common factors other than 1. They are co-prime numbers. So, if a number is divisible by both 8 and 15, then it is also divisible by the product of 8 and 15, that is 120. That number is also divisible by 120. The next rule. If two given numbers are divisible by a number, then their sum is also divisible by that number. So, 12 and 8 both are divisible by 4. Their sum, 12 plus 8, 20. 20 is also divisible by 4. If two given numbers are divisible by a number, then their difference is also divisible by that number. Take 12 and 20, both are divisible by 4. The difference between 12 and 20 is 20 minus 12 is 8. So 8 is also divisible by 4. So let us look at few more problems based on these rules, new rules. So determine if 25,110 is divisible by 45. We have not discussed the rule for 45, divisibility rule for 45. So how can we do? So let us consider the prime factors of 45. So we have 9 and 5, 9 5s of 45. So 9 and 5 are co-prime numbers. So if this number is divisible by both 9 and 5, we can tell this number is also divisible by the product of 5 and 9, that is 45. So check whether it is divisible by 9. So to check, we have to add the digits. So add the digits, 2 plus 5 is 7. 7 plus 1 is 8, 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 plus 0 is 9. The sum of digits here, we get 9. Therefore, this number is divisible by 9. And the unit place of the number 0, if the unit place of a number is 0, then that number is divisible by 5. So, this number, it is divisible by both 5 and 9. Therefore, as 5 and 9 are co-prime numbers, their products, if you take 45, this number is also divisible by 45. Another game, 18 is divisible by both 2 and 3. So 18 is an even number, sum of the digits is 9, 9 comes in third table, therefore it is divisible by both 2 and 3, that means it is also divisible by 6. It is also divisible by the product of 2 and 3, 6. Similarly, if a number is divisible by both 4 and 6, can we say that the number is also divisible by 4 into 6? Here 18 is divisible by 2 and 3, therefore 18 is also divisible by 2 into 3. Similarly, if a number is divisible by 4 and 6, can we say that that number is also divisible by 4 into 6, that is 24. If not, give an example to justify your answer. See here, we have took the two co-prime factors of 45. 9 and 5 are the co-prime factors. So therefore, if a number is divisible by 9 and 5, then that number is also divisible by the product of 9 and 5. But look at here. Here 4 and 6, they are not co-prime numbers. They are not co-prime numbers. Their common factor is not only 1. 2 is also their common factor. Therefore, they are not co-prime numbers. Therefore, so this statement is false. That means if a number is divisible by 4 and 6, then we cannot say that their product, then we cannot say that that number is divisible by the product of 4 and 6, that is 24. So an example is asked here. Let us take 36. So 36 is divisible by 4, that is 4 9s are 36. It is also divisible by 6, 6 6 are 36, but it is not divisible by 24. 6 4s are 24. In 24 table, we will not have 36. 24 1s are 24 and 24 2s are is 48. 36 will not come. That means 36 is not divisible by 24. So if these two numbers are coprime numbers, then only their product divides the given number. So prime factorization, actually this is the introduction for the next video. So you know that 36 can be written as 2 into 18. Here 2 is a prime number. Now write this 18 as a product of another numbers. So 18 can be written as 2 into 9. Here 2 is a prime number, 9 is a composite number. So write 9 as 3 into 3. So now we have all these are prime numbers. 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. So all these are prime numbers. So their product gives 36. So writing in this method is called prime factorization. So writing a given number as the product of two or more prime numbers is nothing but prime factorization. So we can find out this in another method also. It is called factor tree. So instead of 36, here we have taken 90. At the first look, we can write 90 as 10 into 9. 10 9s are 90. Neither 10 nor 9 prime numbers. We can write 10 as 2 into 5. Both 2 and 5 are prime numbers. We can write 9 as 3 into 3. Both 3 and 3 are prime numbers. 3 is a prime number. If we take the product of all these 4 factors, that is 2 into 5 into 3 into 3, we get 90. So 90 can be expressed as 2 into 3 into 3 into 5, or in any other order, 5 into 3 into 3 into 2, or 5 into 3 into 2 into 3, any other order also. But so after the equals, we should have only prime numbers. The expressing of a given number as the product of two or more prime numbers is called prime factorization. So this may be the last problem in this video. So write the prime factorization of 980. So take 980. This is another method. We already discussed a factor tree method, and taking this number as 2 into some number which gives 980. That is one method. For smaller numbers, we can use those methods. For bigger numbers, so take this number and start to divide the given number with the small prime numbers. So here it is an even number. Unit place is 0, therefore it is an even number. Start with 2. So 2 4s are 8. 1 remains. Go to the second place. Second place we have 18 now. So 2 9s are 18 and 0 as it is. So once again we have 0 in the unit place. That means it is an even number. Again divide with 2. So first place is 4. 2 2s are 4. The second place is 9. 2 4s are 8. 1 carries. 1 remains. 1 remains. Go to the third place. In the third place, we have 10. That is 2 5s are 10. Now, it is not an even number. The unit place is 5. So, you can take the next prime number 3 or as we have 5 in the unit place and it is divisible by 5, we can take 5 also. To take 3, you have to check whether the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. If you add them, add the digits, we have 2 plus 4, 6, and 6 plus 5 is 11, which is not divisible by 3. Therefore, we can't divide this number by 3. Therefore, we have to take 5 here. First place is less than 5. Therefore, we have to put a 0 here. But usually, we will not write 0 in the first place. We will go to the second place. So, in the second place, we have 4. But the remainder 2 from the first place, make it as 24. So, 5 4s are 20. 4 remains. And in third place becomes 45. 4 9s are 45. Now, we have 49. So, it is not divisible by 5. So, you know that 7 7s are 49. So, look at here. All these numbers are prime numbers. Therefore, we can write 980 as 2 into 2 into 5 into 7 into 7. The product of these prime numbers gives 980. So, this is called the prime factorization of 980. So, you can write these numbers in any order. You can write it as 2 into 5 into 2 into 7 into 7 or any other order also. But the factors are, so these are the prime factors of 980. So these are the few questions for your assignment. Pause the video and take down these questions. Some of the questions are very simple. Hope you will answer. I am a smallest number having 4 different prime factors. Can you find me? So you have to find out a number which has 4 different small prime factors. So you know that 2 is a prime factor, prime number, 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number, 7 is a prime number. If we take the product of these 4 prime numbers, that is the answer for this question, who am I? And in this figure, you have to fill up these blanks. So, work well. Good luck. Thank you.